Hello everyone, this is Shannon from That's So Poe, and today I am doing my November TBR. If you're not familiar with it, each month I choose a priority to focus on for the month, and I create a TBR. I have a whole playlist of them below if you want to check those out. But what I do is I choose an author type or a voice or a topic that I want to explore more. And I picked 10 books that I would like to prioritize for the month. So not necessarily the only things that I will read in the month, and definitely I won't finish all of them, but it helps me prioritize that topic for the month. For November, my priority is going to be Native American and Indigenous authors. November is Native American Heritage Month in the United States, and there is a readathon called Indigithon hosted by Etu Brody and Thor Needs Another Letter, which I will link below all the information about the Indigithon. It's also Nonfiction November, which is a readathon hosted by Olive at A Book Olive. So this TBR is going to try to combine both of those readathons. We will see how this works out this month. So first, let me talk about the books which satisfy both the Indigithon and Nonfiction November prompts. The Indigithon has a bingo board, which I will put up, that has many, many different prompts, and I will be trying to satisfy as many of those as I can, although I won't get every square. For Nonfiction November, there are 4 word prompts that Olive has come up with, and she very much encourages people to interpret these loosely. I have definitely done so, as well as to just ignore them if you want to read other things. The purpose of Nonfiction November is simply to read more nonfiction than you normally would. Given that I usually read 1 to 2 nonfiction books a month, I think that trying for 4 is definitely going to be a good challenge for me. So the first book on my list that satisfies both of these readathons is Braiding Sweetgrass by Robin Wall Kimmerer. Robin Wall Kimmerer is of the Potawatomi Nation, and this book is something that looks at connecting with nature, understanding its purposes, understanding its uses, and just being a lot more ecologically minded. This is a book that I heard recommended by Andrea at Infinite Text, who I will link below. She read this a couple months ago and loved it, and I wanted to read it ever since. For the Nonfiction November prompts, it satisfies design because it has braiding in the title, so I'm counting that as design. For the Indigithon, it satisfies the nonfiction prompt and the Other Than 5 Civilized Tribe prompts. Almost all of the books that I have chosen satisfy that prompt, actually. Next on my list is Every Day is a Good Day, edited by Wilma Mankiller. First of all, can we just say how great Wilma Mankiller's last name is? I love it. This is a book of short essays by various women of different Indigenous tribes. So we have Comanche and Hopi and Ojibwe and Hawaiian and many, many others. It is all about their experiences. It's about being an Indigenous woman and about what that means, what their lives are like. So I think it's going to be really fascinating and a great insight into many different people's experiences, given how many different tribes this book encompasses. This is going to, for Nonfiction November, satisfy the sport category for me, because one of the women lists her occupation as warrior, and I think that that's close enough to a sport. For the Indigithon, this satisfies the nonfiction prompt, it satisfies the girl power prompt, and it also satisfies the Other Than 5 Civilized Tribes prompt. Next on my list is 1491 by Charles C. Mann. This book is a look at the Americas in pre-Columbian times, hence the title. And it looks at a bunch of the different civilizations, their cultures, their impact, and really tries to delve deep into the history, which is often ignored by colonizing history books. So this book is going to, for Nonfiction November, satisfy the true prompt, because I think it looks at the truth behind what these civilizations actually were in pre-Columbian times. And for the Indigithon, it satisfies quite a few prompts. It satisfies the nonfiction prompt, satisfies the non-native author prompt, because Charles C. Mann isn't native, and it satisfies the Other Than 5 Civilized Tribes prompt, as well as the South American prompt. Next on my list is Heartberries by Therese Marie Melon. Therese Marie Melon is of the Seabird Island Indian Reservation, and this book is her memoir. It is about her experiences going through a lot of various trauma and about dealing with mental health issues and about really finding her voice through writing. So for Nonfiction November, this satisfies the voice prompt, and for the Indigithon, it satisfies the nonfiction and the girl power and the other than five civilized tribes prompts. Now moving on to the fiction reads. First is The Break by Katharina Vermette, who is Métis from Winnipeg. This book focuses on a community that experiences a murder. So it's a little bit of a murder mystery, and it involves a lot of sort of community and family saga. This is the group book for the Indigithon, so it satisfies the group book prompt. It also satisfies the murder mystery and the other than five civilized tribes prompts. Next on my list is The Way of Thorn and Thunder by Daniel Heath Justice, who is Cherokee. This book is the November Book Club pick for the Too Old for This Shit book club run by Ashley at Don't Have a Degree in Reading. I'm really excited about this book, actually, because it sounds just up my alley. It is an epic fantasy told through a post-colonial and environmentalist lens by an Indigenous author. So I'm really excited to read this book. For the Indigithon, it satisfies the SFF prompt as well as the LGBT plus prompt, because I believe there are third genders in this book. Next on my list is Sabrina y Corina by Kali Fajardo Anstein, who is Indigenous Latina. So this is a short story collection that I heard about from Russell at Ink and Paper Block, who I will link below. And this is a collection of short stories about Indigenous Latina women set in the American West, and really focuses on their heritage as well as on their experiences as women. So for the Indigithon prompts, this satisfies the short story collection, the girl power, and the other than five civilized tribes prompts. Next on my list is Split Tooth by Tana Tadak, who is Inuit. She's actually a famous Inuit throat singer, and I'm going to listen to this book on audio because I'm really excited to hear her read it, and because this book is sort of a mixture of both prose and poetry, and poetry is always very good on audio when the author reads it. So this is a story that blends reality and fantasy and really looks at a girl who is growing up in the 1970s in the northernmost parts of Canada and dealing with some trauma. The Indigithon prompts that this satisfies are the poetry collection, the girl power, and the non-five civilized tribes. Next on my list is There There by Tommy Orange, who is Cheyenne and Arapaho. This is a book that was highly, highly recommended by Brody at Etu Brody, and is also a book that I've heard really good things about in other places. It's basically a patchwork quilt contemporary story about a bunch of different people who are getting ready to go to the Big Oakland Powwow. This satisfies the Indigithon prompts of host recommendation as well as other than five civilized tribes. And lastly on my list is The Marrow Thieves by Sherry DeMeline, who is a Georgian Bay Métis out of Ontario. So this is a YA dystopian post-apocalyptic novel after the world has kind of had a lot of ecological disasters. And basically everybody loses the ability to dream and ends up going kind of mad, except for the Indigenous people who are still able to dream. And that means that they get hunted because their bone marrow is a cure for other people's inability to dream and their madness. So I think that this book is gonna be really fascinating and very political, and just a really good read. So I've been looking forward to it. This satisfies the prompts of paranormal and other than five civilized tribes. So those are the books that I am planning to prioritize for November. If anybody else is participating in the Indigithon or is doing one of the group book reads or is doing Nonfiction November, please let me know in the comments down below. I'd love to see what you're going to be reading as well, or if you've read any of the books I've mentioned, please let me know. Also, I wanted to mention that I will not be doing a TBR for December or January because those months I've reserved for TBR catch-up so that I can read all of the different books that don't really fit into one of my monthly priorities, but that I've kind of been dying to read. Plus, I know that December and January, there's going to be a lot of other things going on, including just things like making yearly wrap-up videos in January that are going to take a lot of time. So I'm giving myself a little bit of freedom. In any case, I hope that you guys are looking forward to November. It is just beautiful fall weather here, 40 degrees, clear and crisp and beautiful. So I am very happy and excited about November.